Calvo. I'm Spanish, I'm 30, and I've been living here for the last 4 years and a half already. Matagalna. I work at La Picara as a manager. Yeah, I live in Makati.
Hello, my name is Susana. I'm from Colombia. I moved to the Philippines in 2016, and I've been working in logistics since then.
Hi, I'm Ed. I am 26 years old. I'm from England, the UK. Been in the Philippines for about 3 years now, doing a travel show called Lost in the Philippines, where I go around and explore this crazy, beautiful country.
Hello, guys. Welcome to La Picara. Come in, please. So maybe I should mention that La Picara means maculette, cheeky, naughty, so from the plates to where we serve the food. Sometimes the food is not what it looks like, so it's a little bit cheeky or has influences from other cuisines. And each dish has that witty, cheeky thing, no? That we wanted to have because of La Picara and what everything. I love the Filipino cuisine, and one of the things that bothers me the most is how people don't care about their own gastronomy culture, which is so rich. I find the cuisine amazing, like, and the flavors fantastic. Filipino food is unique because it has influences from many countries. This dish that can be so simple but can be so good if you cook it properly. And I think that happens with everything. Like if you say, I don't like this, well, because you haven't tried a good one. But when you go to somebody's house and you try the food and you realize that it's been developed into something really good, and I was like, wow, this is incredible.
Hello, it's AADA at Salcedo Saturday Market in Makati. Let me show you around. Wood Gourmet, and I have to come here very early. It's my favorite to buy pico. You sold out so soon.
Yeah.
Should I have bought it before?
Maybe.
Okay, let me try the last from the last week. Right now, they already sold out and it's 9 a.m. So I just have to buy like the champurrado one and the tres dulces. So yeah, let's just try it out. So I love to buy natural fruit juices because it actually reminds me very much of Colombia, where we have so many fruits. So at least this is something I can also enjoy here. Don't you have fancy malabok anymore?
No more, mom.
I know where.
I told you a while ago you buy it.
Yes, I should have bought it before.
But only if I can be on order.
Okay, may I get one, please? So I like to come here as I don't eat pork, but I do like the fancy with calamansi, so this is my perfect choice. I enjoy the Salcedo Saturday Market because it allows you to taste a little bit of many Filipino places around. It's definitely a good place to start to know the taste of the Philippines. I got to know Filipino culture through food because wherever there is something to celebrate or something to be grateful for, we always enjoy it with food. I decided to stay because I enjoy my work and I enjoy the people with who I work, and I enjoy my friends which I met here. I think the people makes the place.
Hey guys, I'm Ed, and today I'm going to be making Bicol Express, one of my favorite Philippine dishes. The best Philippine food I've ever always had is always homemade. It's always someone's mom who's making like some badass variation of an adobo. Everyone's just so friendly here. Like everyone really wants you to have a good experience regardless of what it is. My Tagalog's okay. I can speak to taxi drivers, I can entertain people, I know a little bit of, what's the gay lingo called? Is there like a name for it? Like charot, that kind of thing. Gayan tayo, inom tayo, or tagay tayo. I know a lot of the drinking ones. Every foreigner I've met says it when they come to the Philippines, it's just that like the Filipino people really make the country special. It's so true. The spirit here is unlike any other place I've traveled. And I'm truly an adopted Filipino now because I'm leaving behind bread. Normally I would put this in between two slices of bread and have a sandwich. But I'm making rice. I usually cook what I'm inspired by, and I was like, I ate enough Philippine dishes where I was like, damn, this tastes good. Like, I'm gonna try making this myself. Oh, beautiful, love that smell, coconut milk. Coconut, buko. One of the best things about the Philippines is how inventive you guys get with the coconut. You guys do wonderful things with it, including lambanog. We were shooting an episode in Mount Banahaw, and this guy made different types. I've never tasted anything like it. It was phenomenal. He had like bark flavored lambanog. Oh, it's just amazing, right? Bit of rice, bit of pork, bit of chili. Let's give it a go. It's spicy. It's so good. It's its own thing. It's not a Thai green curry. It's a Bicol Express, and I absolutely love it. So good. One of my favorites. Food is a big part of my life. It's for everyone, but I feel like for me, I really enjoy the story that food brings.
I definitely found that Filipinos experience warmth through food, passing through an enjoyable moment or something that they are grateful for. They just buy food for everyone and just share their happiness. So that's something that I'm really interesting about, and something that actually many cultures should learn, like express more those happiness, not like through economic stuff, but just like share the moment and like gather together with the people.
I love the language, I love the food. I always say when they say, are you Spanish? I'm like, Filipina nan puso. I feel so connected to this culture, to the people here.
The Philippines for me is another home, and a place I can rely on.
Philippines, it's a part of my life. Like, it's really become a big part of who I am. It's really helped me to find a more comfortable side of myself, and that's thanks to my experiences here in the Philippines. And I'm really grateful for that opportunity.
Hola, mi nombre es Susana y amo a los Filipinas.
Hello, my name is Isabel Calvo, y me encanta Filipinas.
Hi, my name is Ed, and I love the Philippines.
One of the things I think I learned from Filipinos that I really like is power of positivity. People that manage to give you a smile.
You are so cooperative between each other. Some cultures should really know how to get along in that way.
Super homely, everyone's very warm, welcoming, incredibly friendly, and as soon as you start traveling around, you realize how much this place has to offer.